So hi guys, my name is Nachiketa and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to implement an ARIMA model in Python. In the last video, I had covered autoregression and I've already explained the theoretical concepts behind it. So make sure that you've seen those videos. I'm still going to give you a gist of it as we move along the code. So just let's straight away get started. First step is to install a package called PMD ARIMA. I'm going to tell you why we're exactly using. This is one of the most handy tools you can have for an ARIMA model. And after that, we import pandas as pd, numpy as np. And first step is, of course, to read the data. So I'm going to read a data set which I've already imported onto my workspace. I'm going to leave a link for that in the description as well. And basically, few parameters over here, index column is equal to date, which basically sets the date column as its index, right? And you have to write parse dates equal to true. This makes sure that pandas understand that it's dealing with date values. Otherwise, it will treat it as normal strings, all right? After that, there are some missing values in the dataset which we drop using df.dropNA. After that, you calculate the shape of the dataset and print the first 5 rows just to see how your dataset looks like, right? So dataset has 1821 rows and 5 columns, which you can see over here. It has lots of values about a particular city. We're only interested in average temperature in this case, right? We're going to create a model to predict how the average temperature is going to change with respect to time. So first step is to plot your data just to get a feel of how it looks like. We do that using df.plot, right? And this data set looks pretty much stationary, right? And you don't have to worry about that. We're going to run a fixed statistical test like I shown in the previous video, which is called the augmented Dickey-Fuller test. This is basically a test which returns certain statistical parameters which you can use to judge if a data set is stationary or not. So I've created a function over here. And as I said, this test is going to return an array of values. So we are capturing this different values like the ADF, the P value, the number of lags, number of observation, right? But don't worry about this. We are not going to go in depth about what this test is. Just you should know how to interpret the test, right? So when I'm calling the test, it returns a bunch of values, right? The only value that you need to be bothered about is the P value, right? So basically, if the P value is basically the probability, and it should be as small as possible. If it is a higher value, say 0.8, 0.6, 0.9, that means your data set is not stationary, right? So ideally, it should be less than 0.05, right? The smaller it is, the better. So this is a pretty small value, right? You can see it is exponential raised to the power -9, right? So it's a pretty small value, which means the data set is stationary. We can proceed. After that, the most important step in the ARIMA model is the figuring out the order. Now, I recommend you watch my previous videos on ARIMA, but let me give you a gist of that. ARIMA model basically is divided into 3 parts, right? It has the AR part, which is autoregression, moving average, and integrated. Autoregression basically uses the previous values to make a future prediction. Moving average is going to use the past errors to make a future prediction. And integrated basically means differencing, right? So if your data is not stationary, right, meaning if it has an increasing trend or it has a decreasing trend, you basically difference it, right? You difference it with the previous values to eliminate that trend, right? So for order regression, if it has the second order, it basically means you are using the past 2 values to make a prediction. Similarly, for moving average, if the order is n, right? So it will use the past n errors to make a future prediction. So it goes on like this, and we don't have to worry about any of that. The PMD ARIMA model takes care of everything. We simply import the auto ARIMA function, right? Over here, we're simply importing a library called warnings to ignore any warnings that come up, right? And here is where we call the function, autoARIMA. We have to provide the data set. Over here, trace is equal to true. Basically, what it does is, it will print out as it's iterating to every step, right? So autoARIMA is basically going to try different combinations of orders, right? 100, 010, 012. And for every model, every order, it's going to assign a score, which is called as the AIC, and the goal is to minimize the AIC. So that's how it operates, and it has a lot of parameters that you can check out, like you can mention the starting P value, right? So ARIMA order is basically named as PDQ. So you can mention the starting P value, starting Q value, max P and max T value as well, right? You can do this if it's taking too long to converge. You can specify the starting and the ending points. So over here, we run the autoARIMA function and print out the summary. And it gives you different combinations of model with their respective AIC score. So basically, it's looking for the minimum AIC score, right? So it is given over here as the best model was of 1, 0, 5 order. right? And I know over here it says Sarima, but you can ignore that, right? So Sarima is basically an Arima model with seasonality, right? And since there's no seasonality in our data set, right, this is simply an Arima model. So this is basically an Arima model of order 1, 0, 5. So now we begin with actually fitting the model, right? We call the Arima function from stats models, all right? And the next step is to split the data set into training and testing. You'll train the model on the training section and just check if it's good or not on the testing set, right? So we reserve the last 30 values as the testing section and rest of the data as the training section, all right? And to fit the model, you simply call the Arima function and you give it the data set, which is the training section. You specify the order that you want and you fit that using model.fit. And you can see the summary as well if you want. So in the summary, you can see a lot of things like the AIC score, the order of the model, and you can see the respective coefficient for each time lag, right? For the autoregression of order 1, the coefficient is 0.98. And for the 5 moving average parameters, you can see the coefficient for them as well. After that, we proceed to make finally predictions on the testing section, right? You do that using model.predict. And for model.predict, you need to provide the starting index and the ending index in which you want to make a prediction, right? So the starting index is length of training set. So basically where the training set ends, from there you want to start making prediction, and it goes on till the end of the data set. All right. So you mention that over here in model.predict, right? And over here you print out the prediction. So you can see the prediction for the testing set over here. Sometimes what happens is the index is not date values, and instead it gives them numbers as the first prediction, second prediction, third prediction. But you always need to have dates as the index over here if you want to make a plot, right? If you want to plot it out, you need the date values. So in some cases, you might have to use this line, which is basically taking the date values from the data frame and you're assigning over here as the index of the prediction model. Sometimes you might have to do this if the index is not as date. Over here, the index are date values, so we don't have any problem. After that, we are plotting the prediction and we are plotting the test set along with it to see a comparison, right? And you can see the model is pretty good. It's following the trend of the data set. And if you want to see exactly how good or bad it is, you can check the root mean squared error, right? So over here, we import the mean squared error function from sklearn.metrics, and we are calculating the mean squared error between prediction and the test values and taking a square root of that to get the root mean squared. And the value is 2.32, and to get a sense of how good or bad this is, you have to check out the mean of a data set, right? So the mean over here is 45 and the average error is 2, right? So that's acceptable. If the root mean squared error is very similar in range to the mean of the data set, then it becomes a bad model, right? So that's it, we are done, but we still haven't made predictions on future values. We are only making predictions on the test set so far, right? So now that we know the model is good, we retrain the model on the entire data set this time and not just the training section. So I'm printing the last 5 values to see at what date my data set ends, and from there I'm going to make a prediction on the next 30 days. So what I'm doing over here is, again, I'm calling the model, right? I'm making predictions from the end of the data set to the next 30 days. So when you actually print your predictions, you will see that the index is not dates, right? So we simply have the number of prediction. We simply have, it's the 18,021st prediction, 18,022nd prediction. Now you can't plot this without having date values. So first we create an index of dates, right? We create dates ranging from 2018 30th December to the next 30 dates. And what we're doing is basically, we're basically assigning index to this prediction data frame and setting it as the future dates, right? So now if you try to print it, you'll see that the indexing has been changed to dates. Now you'll be able to plot this easily. So now when you plot this, right, you'll see this is how your future predictions look like, right? So it's basically around between 46.4 and 45.2, I think, right? So that's how you use an Arima model. And that was all for this video. In the future videos, I'm going to talk about different models and how you can use that for more complex time predictions. So if you did like this video, do like it and subscribe to this channel. And yeah, thank you for watching.